Interfaces in TypeScript. Interfaces are basically contracts that defines a structure and a syntax which an implementing class should follow. An interface can be implemented by a class. Such classes will be the implementing classes. Now this is the syntax to define an interface. To define an interface, the interface keyword is used, followed by the name of the interface. The body of the interface is surrounded by curly braces, and in the body, we define the properties, the fields and the methods. So this was about the syntax of interface. Let us check out an interface in action. So here I am in the VS Code editor. In our demo app, I am continuing with our demo app which we had created in the previous chapter. I have only added a new file person.ts here in my app directory. I have simply created a simple basic interface here. I have added two properties to the interface, a string type name and a number type age. We don't need the let or var keyword to define the properties in the interface. Now any object that implements this interface will have to inherit these two properties. Now let's see a slightly more complex example. I have added another interface here, developer. This developer interface has two properties, domain and experience. I have used the extends keyword to specify that this interface will extend the person interface, which means the developer interface will inherit all the members of the person interface as well as have its own property. It is not explicitly listed here, but it is known that we have the name and age property as well in the developer interface. I can also add a method to this developer interface, let's say develop. The method in the interface just have the signature and no implementation. Also notice that we don't need a function keyword while defining a method in the interface. The develop method takes one parameter, which is of string type, and then it returns void. So here we have just defined the shape of the object which will implement the developer interface. The object will have four properties: name, age, domain and experience, and one method develop. Let us now see how we can use the structural type system of TypeScript. This uses the structure of the object as type. Let's see how. Now I'll paste a piece of code here. And this code has defined a player object. This player object has three properties: name, age, and score. Now looking at the person interface that we have here, it has two properties: name and age. And this object literal also has these two properties: name and age. And here, the third property score is not on the person interface, but it implements all the property that the person interface has. So even if it is not explicitly mentioned here, this player object implements the person interface. It can be used anywhere where a person interface is expected. So I can declare a variable like this as well. Here, this variable another person is of person type and I have assigned an object literal to it which implements the person interface, this player object. So this is basically the structural type system of TypeScript. As long as the structure matches, we can treat an object as that structural type. This is called duck typing in TypeScript. So now let us create some interfaces that we will use in our demo app. We will now use more than one file in our demo. For each interface and classes that we create, we will have a new file. This is actually a good practice to structure our project. To begin with, I'll just clear all the code in this person.ts file. But before moving forward to add interface in this file, we need to make few changes in our configuration to support multiple files. I'll temporarily stop using Webpack to compile the code. We will run the compiler from the terminal from now. So in the Webpack config file, I'll first change the entry point to main.js from the JS folder. And then I'll comment out everything else in the configuration file except for the section at the bottom that configures the dev web server. I'll use this dev server to serve the app to the browser. Next, in the index.html file, I'll have to update the reference to the JavaScript file to be main.js. Done. So that's all we need to set up to run the compiler from the terminal. Now let's begin with creating interfaces. And here is my person interface. I have defined one property, name. Notice here I have added question mark with the property name. This, like the function parameter, marks the property as optional. The objects which implement this person interface are now not required to implement this member. On hovering over it, the compiler also marks the type as string or undefined. If I remove this question mark, the tooltip now gives me the type of this property as only string. I'll keep this as a required property. Now the other thing in this interface is the function member format name. It takes no parameter and returns a string. This member is not optional, so the implementing object has to implement this function. Now I'll create another interface, a result interface. For that, I'll create a new file result.ts. This result interface will represent the result obtained for a game. This again is a basic interface. It has three properties and no methods. I want objects that implement this interface to be able to store the name of the player, the score they got in the game, and the number of problems they solved in the game. I'm using this simple example just for the demo, just to clear out the underlying concepts. I could have created a class with the same property, but since I don't have any methods to implement and I'll be using object literals to implement the interface, I don't really need the additional features offered by the classes. So here, my result interface is ready and the person interface is ready. We will see how to implement the interfaces in classes, but now we will just use the object literals until we learn about classes in the next lesson. So let me first create an object literal for this result interface. I'll do it in this file itself. I'll create a new variable, say new result, and annotate its type to be of result interface. Now when I initialize this to an empty object literal, you see I get an error here. The compiler tells me the object is missing the following properties from type result: player name, score, and number of problems. Now you see, if I mark this as optional, I just need the score and number of problems and not the player name in the object literal. I'll remove this. I will add the properties to this result object. So let me add them. Player name Anna, score 5 and number of problems 4. We are good to go now. Coming back to the person interface, I'll define another object literal here which implements the person interface. I have declared a new variable called new player and defined it to be of person type. I've implemented the two members of the person interface, the name and the format name function. The format name function will return a trimmed version of the name. I've hard-coded it here for now. So this is how the object literals can implement the interface. This is just for the demo to show you how it works. I've created the object literals in the interface file itself. However, this is not the correct place to have this implementations. Interface in TypeScript is a development time tool. This means the compiler uses interface for type checking during compilation, but do not compile the interface to anything in JavaScript. I'll show you how. Now when I open the terminal, Control plus backtick and create a new terminal, I'll go to the app folder and compile this new interface file which I have created, tsc.person.ts. Now I have this person.js file created here, and this code is just for the object literal which I had created here in my person.ts file. However, the code for this interface person is not mentioned anywhere in my JavaScript file. Thus, we can say the interface is compiled but has no work in the runtime. So I'll delete this person.js file for now. It was just to show you how this works. So this was all about interfaces. We will use this in our demo application. However, we do not need this objects which we have created for our demo app. So I'll remove it from the interface files, from result, as well as from the person file. And now we are good to go. Let us now check out classes in TypeScript and take our demo app a step further.